is tricky. But when I look back, Paul, to when we fished, I'll often visualize us on the test in that in the sun,
In May, yeah.
midsummer's day. It's hard to beat.
It is in terms of like just the backdrop, isn't it? And that sort of gin clear water and the, you know, the mayflies. And there's something very alive about it, isn't there? The world is full of life. So yeah, that's beautiful. I would also, I mean, one of my favorite months would be September for all species, really, Chris, you know, everything. So I was going to say, if I'm allowed two times a year, I'll go for May and September.
I think it would be, I think I would start with a fry up because the smell of outdoor bacon is a great pleasure. And we also we used a gadget when we were fishing the Christmas show that makes toast from a camping stove, and it worked very well. So yeah, I think bacon, egg, beans, tomato, toast, and foraged mushrooms, what Paul
Definitely
calls it.
orange mushrooms, yeah. No, can we've lost the sausage. That's probably a good thing, Bob.
It's a good thing,
Got to
isn't
make some concession to heart health.
it?
Yeah. To arrive by train, wouldn't you, Bob, really?
Steam train.
We like a train, don't we?
Yeah. Steam train, but one of our cars is waiting for us to go
Yeah,
to the river.
the river. Or an Argo cat.
There's nothing like your own car.
No, there's certainly nothing like your car. The interior of his car is, well, my God. I mean, if health and safety were allowed to inspect a car, it wouldn't be declared roadworthy, Bob.
It's a hoarder's car, isn't it?
It is.
I tend to find old pork pies or pizzas or sausage rolls in the glove box. I mean, Chris, it's difficult to express what my car's like. It's not like, oh, there's a little bit of junk in there. It's, I don't know, it's the lair of a monster, isn't it? Well, it doesn't.
If there weren't known life in the universe, there's a good chance it could start in your car, isn't there, Bob?
Yes, I'm glad the Wuhan scientists types haven't been near it.
I'm quite happy in Bob's car, actually, because usually he's got so much sugar in there. I mean, honestly, you know that. That if we find somewhere to grab a cup of coffee, Bob, at least I know that I've got some sugar, haven't I?
Yeah, so that's something, and I've got cinnamon in there as well.
Yeah, and I don't mind an old Haribo stuck to my arse when I get out that you've left on the seat.
I wonder how much debris is attached to your I know you've had peanuts on your ass.
It bad when you've gone about your daily business and you realise that something has been stuck to your ass for
Yeah.
a significant proportion of that day.
For that day, yeah.
Oh, how long's that been there?
Yeah. So we're going to the Y, Paul.
And the way in September,
On a steam plane in my car.
we'll keep it low tech, really, won't we, Bob? For me, anyway, I would use sort of roll some meats, you know, that sort of thing, and we'd probably prospect a little bit, but obviously we would have done our prep and got John Bailey to find some barber, wouldn't we?
That's the thing, yeah. I did go with my son back to the Y. And we got some a nice chub, but I rolled meat for a barbell, didn't
No.
get one, but we're going for a barbell. I mean, I
In
think,
our dream scenario, Bob, though, we won't be bothered by canoes, will we? Because you had a lot of canoes that day, didn't you?
every minute and a half or something, yeah.
Yeah, so in our dream Y scenario, there are no canoes.
No canoes, yeah. I would
Or
agree with
there
that.
might be one, a cheery one, who's very careful of where we're fishing and just glides past and says, "What ho?"
So I reckon, Paul, what about you roll your meat?
Yeah, huge float fish.
And I think I'll trot down for see if I can get myself a chub. Nice chub, yeah.
Yeah, bit of maga. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. Lovely. John Bailey because he works hard for us, doesn't he, Bob?
Yeah.
And you know, John and I sort out a lot of the venues and, you know, tactics and species for that matter. So I have a lot of liaison with John, but so we want him there definitely. But I tell you, we really loved fishing with was Charlie Cooper, wasn't it, Bob?
Oh, Charlie's like, because Charlie,
he's a really nice guy, isn't he?
A lovely guy and really passionate about his. I get the feeling he's not been fishing forever, has he?
I think he's reasonably new, but he's a young person with an absolute passion for angling, isn't he?
Yeah.
That's lovely to see because, you know, the demographic is slightly older usually, isn't it, angling? So it's lovely to see that. And he's really intense about it, isn't he, Bob?
He is, and it's nice, Paul, if you're fishing with someone to, you know, as the hours go by, to be absolutely confident that they're just as happy as you, because, yeah, they love the fishing.
Yeah, exactly,
So that's a very good combination.
Isn't it?
The Bailey-Cooper method.
Yeah. Well, we did stay on that wonderful place on the Wye, didn't we, Bob?
Yeah.
It's like that sort of high cliff bank, wasn't it? Looking down, that's amazing, wasn't it?
Probably the most. I think it's between that one and the Wye and the boathouse on Ullswater for the best we've ever stayed in. Do you think?
Yeah, that boathouse was extraordinary, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And that was, you couldn't have been more on the water, could you? Really?
Amazing, yeah.
Over the water. But I'm going to suggest something else, Bob. I'm going to say. Can we stay in a really good pub?
We've never done it, have we?
We have, but not in the show, have we?
I tell you, I don't know whether we're allowed to name things, Paul, but I've always got fond memories of the Angel Hotel we stayed in Abergavenny.
Yes.
Which is within striking distance.
Yeah, we could. We could stop off at the Usk on the way and have or on the way back.
Yeah.
A little cast for a trout on the way back, actually, on the Us.
Yes. That's an idea.
Yeah, it is, yeah. There we go.
Yeah, we must do that sometime, Paul, on the show if we do any more. Just stay at the pub.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Pie. It's always pie, isn't it, Bob?
Pie, yeah.
This dream scenario. Where heart disease doesn't exist, it's pie. I quite like new potatoes or mash. Bob will go for the chip straight away, won't you?
I like to have mash with a pie. I do.
Oh, right. Oh.
Mash, yeah.
A lot of gravy.
Peas.
Throw some peas at it.
I've written peas. And then that's the way to end the day, isn't it?
I'm going for a sticky toffee pudding and all, Bob.
I'd have syrup sponge.
Right. There we go.
It's getting so hard. My wife doesn't believe me. It's getting so hard to get a pie these days. I was up at a nice place near Middlesbrough this weekend looking for a post-football pie.
Yeah.
No pie. It's very frequent. I wonder if it's a health thing. I think they shouldn't put a pie on or something.
We knew. Do you remember one of the conversations we had while doing an episode of Gone Fishing? We were going to start a little pie company. Do you remember?
Intense.
Sipco, we called it.
That's right.
Small Intense Pie Company. A little.
One big pie. Pie.
But the pork pie holds sway over everything, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's not my favourite. Why don't the people do mini, like a mini steak and kidney or a mini chicken and ham, you know?
I suppose the pork pie holds sway because you can enjoy it cold, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose, yeah.
I suppose that's its...
Yeah.
That's a superpower kind of thing.
Yeah, like a sausage roll, isn't it, as well?
Roll, yeah.
Without
the pie, I'd have, I'm going to say 4 pints of bitter.
Right.
You would probably have something like a lager, but then turn to wine.
Exactly. I'd kick off with a lager, and then with the food, I'd have a nice bottle of plonk wine.
And then, Paul, you'd get into a... Have I got any chocolate frenzy?
Oh, I thought you were going to say a fight, Bob. I had a chocolate frenzy once, didn't I?
Yeah. I've never seen anything like it, Paul. You were like an escaped primate.
Yeah, I was.
Chocolate, please.
I was smashing things up, wasn't I?
Yeah.
Welsh dresser went out the window, didn't it?
Out the window, yeah. Left the
top in the bed.
So, yeah, there's chocolate at the end.
Got to be chocolate, isn't
there? I think Paul's Galaxy, but he's not that fussy.
No, I'm not. I'm not bothered.
That's the thing. Yeah. That's the thing. You want to. Old men, you know, you need to tuck your way into a dark corner, don't you? Mumble.
Mumble, yeah.
Complain.
Bitter about everything, even when you're enjoying it.